Greetings! Gonna do the warrior. Got the butcher.
Hello, my friend. Stay a while and listen. Ogden has owned and run the Rising Sun Inn and Tavern for almost 4 years now. He purchased it just a few short months before everything here went to hell. He and his wife, Garda, do not have the money to leave as they invested all they had in making a life for themselves here. He is a good man, with a deep sense of responsibility.
What the f...
Ogden has... Hello, my friend, Ogden.
I'm not thirsty. What can I do for you?
Well, what can I do for you?
Premium items.
I was with Farnham that night that Lazarus led us into the labyrinth. I never saw the Archbishop again, and I may not have survived if Farnham was not at my side. I fear that the attack left his soul as crippled as, well, another did my leg. I cannot fight this battle for him now. But what if I could?
Greetings,
Thank
traveler.
Thank goodness you returned. Much has changed since you lived here, my friend. All was peaceful until the Dark Riders came and destroyed our village. Many were cut down where they stood, and those who took up arms were slain or dragged away to become slaves, or worse. The church at the edge of town has been desecrated and is being used for dark rituals. The screams that echo in the night are inhuman, but some of our townsfolk may yet survive. Follow the path that lies between my tavern and the blacksmith's shop to find the church and save who you can. Perhaps I can tell you more if we speak again. Good luck.
So, go to a really deadly place, possibly die. I might have a chat with you if you come back.
Good day.
Jillian, the big barmaid.
Cain has been the storyteller of Tristram for as long as I can remember. He knows so much, and can tell you just about anything. About almost everything.
Isn't that such a big mushroom? Good day to you.
What ails you, my friend? Poor Wirt. I did all that was possible for the child, but I know he despises that wooden peg that I was forced to attach to his leg. His wounds were hideous. No one, and especially such a young child, should have to suffer the way he did.
And Wirt's creeping out on the corner of Julian. If I remember right. Somewhere. God, how friggin' dark this game is.
Psst, over here. I guess I owe the blacksmith my life. What there is of it. Sure, Griswold offered me an apprenticeship at the smithy. He's a nice enough guy, but I'll never get enough money to... Well, let's just say that I have definite plans that require a large amount of gold.
Hmm. I've got 100 pieces. What's Wirt got for 50? Instant regret because I'll get killed by something inside.
Over here.
Son of a bitch. I forgot he charges me to look. Thieving little goit. Let's talk to Farnham. Please, listen to me. The Archbishop Lazarus.
Can't a fellow drink in peace? Why don't that old crone do something for a change? Sure, she's got stuff. Will you listen to me? She's unnatural. I ain't never seen her eat or drink. And you can't trust somebody who doesn't drink at least a little.
Sound advice, Phantom. Sound advice.
Hello, my friend. Ogden has all...
I would if I could! Yes, it's further down. Oh, no. Nope, it's there. I sense a soul in search of answers. Ginormous bazongas.
I sense a soul in search of answers. Earth and walls and thatched canopy do not a home create. The innkeeper Ogden serves more of a purpose in this town than many understand. He provides shelter for Jillian and her matriarch, maintains what life Farnham has left to him, and provides an anchor for all who are left in the town to what Tristram once was. His tavern and the simple pleasures that can still be found there provide a glimpse of a life that the people here remember. It is that memory that continues to feed their hopes for your success.
Excellent. Not quite sure what pissing off the cows can achieve, but there we are. Listen to me.
Please, listen to me. The Archbishop Lazarus, he led us down here to find the lost prince. Bastard led us into a trap. Now everyone is dead, killed by a demon he called the Butcher. Avenge us! Find this butcher and slay him, so that our souls may finally rest.
Your death will be avenged. Your death will be... The sanctity of this place has been fouled. I can't use this yet. I can't use this yet. I don't have a spell ready. Please, listen to me. Thank you. I can't use this yet. I can't use this yet.
Hello, my friend. Stay a while and listen. Hello, my friend. Stay a while and listen.
Well, what can I do for you?
A fellow drinking tea?
Big cleaver, killing all my friends. Couldn't stop him.
Had to run away. Couldn't save them. Trapped in a room with so many bodies. So many friends. No!
Oh. my friend. It seems that the Archbishop Lazarus goaded many of the townsmen into venturing into the labyrinth to find the king's missing son. He played upon their fears and whipped them into a frenzied mob. None of them were prepared for what lay within the cold earth. Lazarus abandoned them down there, left in the clutches of unspeakable horrors. To it see, Griswold.
Well, what can I do for you? I saw what Farnham calls the butcher as it swathed a path through the bodies of my friends. He swung a cleaver as large as an axe, hewing limbs and cutting down brave men where they stood. I was separated from the fray by a host of small screeching demons, and somehow found the stairway leading out. I never saw that hideous beast again, but his blood-stained visage haunts me to this day.
Greetings, good master. Welcome to the Tavern of the Rising Sun. Yes, Farnham has mumbled something about a hulking brute who wielded a fierce weapon. I believe he called him a butcher.
Good day. How may I serve you? When Farnham said something about a butcher killing people, I immediately discounted it. But since you brought it up,
well,
it is true.
She clearly knows nothing. And I'm not falling for Wirt's trickery again. That's a mushroom. That is a big mushroom.
Psst, over here. I know more than you think about that grizzly fiend. His little friends got a hold of me and managed to get my leg before Griswold pulled me out of that hole. I'll put it bluntly. Kill him before he kills you and adds your corpse to his collection.
Whoa! Gnarly! Because they fallen. Gnarled his leg, you see. Huh, weak joke here. What are you? I'm a magic warrior. Let's talk to Pepin.
What ails you, my friend? By the light, I know of this vile demon. There were many that bore the scars of his wrath upon their bodies when the few survivors of the charge led by Lazarus crawled from the cathedral. I don't know what he used to slice open his victims, but it could not have been of this world. It left wounds festering with disease, and even I found them almost impossible to treat. Beware if you plan to battle
beware,
this fiend.
Beware, go back.
Thank you.
So the state of a lot of my Let's Plays these days are going to be no audio or little commentary, unless people pop up in the chat and there's reasons to actually talk.
The Butcher is a sadistic creature that delights in the torture and pain of others. You have seen his handiwork in the Drunkard Farnham. His destruction will do much to ensure the safety of this village.
Was there not a stash in Diablo 1 for your gold? I don't remember. Please, listen to me. That is not the way I want to go. May have been silly in selling that tome, because obviously I'm sure you can obviously learn certain magics. You just have to get your magic level up. Oh. Back here, you little bugger. Oh, God damn it. your ability doesn't make them better. Ah, excellent. I kind of wasted, but didn't. There's fire! Picking up my tattered rags. Really? It's a level 3 already? Get a bit of dexterity. On vitality. Gold in a barrel. Okay. My tattered rags are not very good as defensive items. Phones beeping and buzzing and vibrating. Really? Ooh, scimitar. 1 to 8, 3 to 7. Oh, that's the damage 2 to 6. Oh yeah, it's way better. What? Who are you? Why are you here? All these distractions is enough to make one mad. Not enough mana. Oh, that was a waste. Is there no self-regeneration in Diablo?
Not enough mana. Not enough mana.
Okay. That suddenly ramped up the difficulty, didn't it? I used nearly all my damn healing items. A falchion, damage 4 to 8. Falchion, then. Back off.
Too much baggage.
I should probably run away, to be fair. Well, what can I do for you? How much gold? 1500.
Hello, my friend. Stay a while and listen. Well, what can I do for you?
Twenty, 30, 11, and 9. Excellent.
I can't use this yet.
Alright, next level up, I'm gonna get magic.
What ails you, my friend?
Right. I've partially unhanded my own ass to me. Well, that sucked ass. Whoa. You can gain some levels.
Not enough mana. Not enough mana. Not enough mana.
One at a time, one at a time. That could have been interesting. Oh, I wasted that health potion.
I can't use this yet.
It's kind of weird. You think about it, your warrior, it's worth getting at least a very basic level of magic. But you are predominantly better with vitality and strength as the warrior. To say that you're the silent, strong idiot type, you'd be like, whoa. Not sure if we should be coming across the butcher sometime soon. Isn't this his door? Too much crap to carry. I am overburdened. Yes, almost will be. Well, that was the worst. Oh, fuck off. One at a time, please. Thank you.
baggage.
Chupacabra. Do you know, it's funny, because I keep hearing their equipment drop. I keep thinking there's like been a drop for me. Not his room, is it? King Leoric's tomb? Shouldn't I have come across the butcher by now? I missed the butcher. How the hell am I at King Leoric's tomb? I could have sworn the butcher's on like level 2. As I begin my long, slow-ass journey back. Oh. Dude, fucking hit them. Oh, Christ, that was lucky. Next level up's gotta be strength and vitality. So have I missed anywhere? I don't think I have.
Your death will.
Your death will. Well, what can I do for you?
Good day. How may I? The woman at the edge of town is a witch. She seems nice enough, and her name Adria is very pleasing to the ear. But I'm very afraid of her. It would take someone quite brave like you to see what she is doing out there.
Oh, you know, you can just go and talk to her.
The village needs your help, good master. Some months ago, King Leoric's son, Prince Albert, was kidnapped. The king went into a rage and scoured the village for his missing child. With each passing day, Leoric seemed to slip deeper into madness. He sought to blame innocent townsfolk for the boy's disappearance and had them brutally executed. Less than half of us survived his insanity. The king's knights and priests tried to placate him, but he turned against them and, sadly, they were forced to kill him.
Shown in Diablo 3.
With his dying breath, the king called down a terrible curse upon his former followers. He vowed that they would serve him in darkness forever. This is where things take an even darker twist than I thought possible. Our former king has risen from his eternal sleep and now commands a legion of undead minions within the labyrinth. His body was buried in a tomb 3 levels beneath the cathedral. Please, good master, put his soul at ease by destroying his now cursed form. Greetings, good master. Welcome to the tavern of the...
Yes. Yes, Farnham has mumbled something about a hulking brute who wielded a fierce weapon.
As I told you, good master, the king was entombed 3 levels below. He's down there, waiting in the putrid darkness for his chance
putrid
to destroy
darkness.
His land.
Good day. How may I serve? I don't like to think about how the king died. I like to remember him for the kind and just ruler that he was. His death was so sad and seemed very wrong somehow.
What ails you, my friend?
What ails you, my friend? The loss of his son was too much for King Leoric. I did what I could to ease his madness, but in the end, it overcame him. A black curse has hung over this kingdom from that day forward. But perhaps, if you were to free his spirit from his earthly prison, the curse would be lifted.
We unfortunately know that that doesn't happen.
Hello, my friend. Stay a while and listen. Hello, my friend. Stay a while. Ah, the story of our king, is it?
Ah.
The tragic fall of Leoric was a harsh blow to this land. The people always loved the king, and now they live in mortal fear of him. The question that I keep asking myself is how he could have fallen so far from the light. As Leoric had always been the holiest of men, only the vilest powers of hell could so utterly destroy a man from within.
Well, what can I do for you?
I mean, it's good, but...
I made many of the weapons and most of the armor that King Leoric used to outfit his knights. I even crafted a huge two-handed sword of the finest mithril for him, as well as a field crown to match. I still can't believe how he died, but it must have been some sinister force that drove him insane.
Falchion. That's...
I can't use this yet.
Well, what can I do for you?
If it gets... if it disappears, then it disappears.
Time to fellow drinking tea.
I don't care about that. Listen.
No, no skeleton is gonna be my king.
Leoric is king. King! So you hear me? Hail to the king!
No skeleton, man. No skeleton's gonna be my king. Leoric is king.
I sense a soul in search of answers.
Whip out your tits.
Walk among the living, follow the cursed king. He holds the power to raise yet more warriors for an ever-growing army of the undead. If you do not stop his reign, he will surely march across this land and slay all who still live here.
I don't know what the phasing does, but yeah, go on then, I'll sell it. I'll spend a little bit of gold. Being able to come back to town from the level will be a bit nicer. If I remember correctly, that's why in Diablo 2 they made the tomes of Scrown Portal. Scrown? Town Portal. And that you could add the scrolls to. So although it took up 4 inventory spaces, you could hold 20 scrolls instead of obviously having to have 20 inventory spaces, which would have been, you know, which is 5 tomes worth.
Psst, over here. Look, I am running a business here. I don't sell information, and I don't care about some king that's been dead longer than I've been alive. If you need something to use against this king of the undead, then I can help you out.
What, you little shit? The king's not even dead. Well, not that bloody long. Let me just scroll. I've not missed any doors. You know ye. Maybe it was after the Skeleton King. Oh, haven't been up there. Yeah, fuck off crowded me. To the door! As I said, Bone Ripper didn't drop us anything. Oh, wait, there's some gold. Oh shit, it's gold. Thank you. Yeah, I bloody knew I'd missed him. Not such a big mushroom. Not enough mana. Not enough manners.
Friend, stay a while and listen.
I can't cast that here.
Dull staff of Firebolt. Why do I keep hitting the wrong buttons?
Well, what can I do for you?
Alright, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sell this staff and then we're going to defeat the butcher. And then I'll call it a stream for now, because I'm going to go off and do some other stuff. What a Dinkelberg, though.
I sense a soul in search of answers.
Are you serious? I lost 99 gold on that piece of shit. What ails you, my friend? Well, what can I do for you? Greetings, good master. Stay a while and listen.
What ails you, my friend?
Freshman. No more Mr. Nice Guy. No more Mr. Glee. So this, a guy I'm watching just recently, Dark Lord Dash, got some really good videos. Got obviously a lot of people go into more of this lore than I do. I remember playing this back when it first came out and finishing it. Finally finished Diablo 2, ironically enough, in order, some years back. I'd played it, missed a mission, like, section, did the ending, ended up playing through it properly. Obviously, I finished Diablo 3, and I'm awaiting Diablo 4, but yeah, interesting. Won't be the first to mention it, but yes, he's got some good, real good lore video run through. And this place was supposed to have, like, a traveling priest who could come and go. Quest with him.
Fresh meat.
Not enough mana.
Of the dead are now avenged.
You can kind of punk ass him if you level 8, that's for sure. If you are level 8, you can punk ass him really easily.
Greetings, good master. Welcome to the tavern. Word is a rapscallion and a little scoundrel. He was always getting into trouble, and it's no surprise what happened to him. He probably went fooling about someplace that he shouldn't have been. Well, I feel sorry for the boy, but I don't abide the company that he keeps.
Well, what can I do for you? A good man who puts the needs of others above his own. You won't find anyone left in Tristram, or anyone else for that matter, who has a bad thing to say about the healer.
So the one thing about Diablo 1, if you notice, there's no end of quest.
Hello, my friend. Stay a while and listen. While you are venturing deeper into the labyrinth, you may find tomes of great knowledge hidden there. Read them carefully.
Yeah. It might be that I've kind of broken it, but yes, there isn't a direct ending of quest. Going to save for now. This is a good part for me to end. And join me sometime later in a couple of hours for part 2, shall I say, where I shall go and fight the Skeleton King. Thank you for joining.